Welcome students. Today we are going to study about parts of the flower. There are different parts of a typical angiospermic flower and we will study about those parts. We know that flower is the reproductive part of an angiospermic plant. It is responsible for sexual reproduction in plant, and for that it has various parts, various organs, male parts, female parts, and some accessory parts which help in the process of reproduction. So let's study in details about a typical flower. Students, a typical flower has four parts. As you can see here, I have drawn the diagram. A typical flower has four parts. The very first part is called calyx. It is the outermost hole of the flower. If we start observing a flower, the first part that we will find is calyx. Calyx is the outermost hole of the flower. A single unit of a calyx is called sepal. Calyx is the combination of all the sepals. A flower may have three or five sepals, and that's what makes it pentamerous, trimerous flower, as we have studied, discussed in the last video. Trimerous means having three floral appendages or in a multiple of three. Pentamerous is having five or multiple of five floral appendages. So, if it is a pentamerous flower, it means it is having five sepals, and the combination of five sepal is called calyx. A single leaf is called sepal, and all together is called calyx. These are usually green in color. It protects the flower, especially during in its bud stage. When flower is in its bud stage, it is closed and we can see only this calyx. So at that time, the function of calyx is to protect the inner holes of the flower. The sepals of the calyx may be free from each other, and that condition is called polysepalous. Means all the different sepals are free from each other. This condition is called polysepalous. In some flowers we can see these sepals are united. That condition is called gamosepalous. Means if sepals are free, each sepal can be individually taken out. It is called polysepalous condition. And condition where sepals are united or attached together, it is called gamosepalous. So there are two conditions, polysepalous and gamosepalous. The second hole of the flower, you can see I have drawn it with red color, is called corolla. The combination, the entire hole together is called corolla, and a single unit, a single leaf is called petal. It is the second hole of the flower, and these are brightly colored and sometimes scented leaves, depending upon again being free or being fused. These may be polypetalous when these are free. In this condition you can see all the petals are free, it is polypetalous. And if petals are combined together, it is gamopetalous condition. The function of petal, that it helps in the process of pollination. Being brightly colored or scented, it attracts the insects. Insects, butterflies sit on the flower to collect nectar, and in that way they transfer pollen grain from one flower to another, and that way petals are useful, helpful in the process of pollination. In some flowers, the sepals and petals cannot be distinguished. There only a single hole is present, and that hole is called perianth. That is neither termed as calyx nor termed as corolla, but that hole is termed as perianth. And a single unit of that perianth is called tepals. That condition where calyx and corolla are not distinguishable, the whole is called perianth and a single unit of that perianth is called tepal. So these two, that is calyx and corolla, are two accessory part of the flower which do not take part in reproduction directly, but these help in reproduction process. Now we will study about aestivation, but before that we must know about rest two parts of the flower. The third hole of the flower is called androecium. Androecium is the male reproductive part of the flower which produces male gamete. A single unit of androecium is called a stamen. You can see the structure of a stamen. The fourth part of the flower is called gynoecium. It is the innermost hole of the flower which represents the female reproductive part of the flower. It produces female gamete. A single unit of gynoecium is called carpel or pistil. So these are four different holes of the flower. The outer one calyx, second corolla, third androecium and fourth gynoecium. A single unit of calyx is called sepal, single unit of corolla is called petal, single unit of androecium is called stamen and single unit of gynoecium is called carpel. Now we will study about the arrangement of sepals or petals in flower with respect to other members of the same hole, means the relation between two sepals or two petals. This is called aestivation. Aestivation means the arrangement of sepals or petals in flower with respect to other member of the same hole, that is sepal and petal itself, is called aestivation. Means how two sepals or two petals are arranged together. What is the relation of two sepals or two petals together? So that arrangement is called aestivation. It is of five types. The first one is called velvet. In such type of aestivation, sepal or petals are parallel to each other and just touch the margin of each other without overlapping it. You can see over here, the margins of two sepals or petals are not overlapping each other. If they are extended, they will touch only the margins of each other. So such type of aestivation where all the floral holes of sepals or petals are just touching the margin of each other without overlapping is called velvet aestivation. It is found in the flowers like Solanum, Calotropis, etc. The second one is twisted. As the name suggests, the petals or sepals are twisted together. Margins of sepals or petals overlap each other. You can see over here, one margin, this margin is outside and the margin of other petal is inside. So this is the inside of this, it is exterior, it is interior. The next margin is exterior. The next sepal or petal, first margin is interior over here and it is exterior. So in this condition we find that one side of the petal is interior and another side is exterior, and it is in such a way, so it makes a twisted form and it is called twisted aestivation. You can find such aestivation in China rose, lady finger, etc. The third example is called imbricate. In imbricate, a single petal is completely outside. Both the margins are external. Another petal is completely inside. Both the margins are internal. rest are in twisted manner. So if five petals are there, one is extreme outside completely external, one is inside completely, and rest three are in twisted manner. It is called imbricate. Example, Gulmohar. The fourth type of estivation is not very common. It is found rarely. Here, two petals are completely external. You can see this petal and this petal I have drawn completely external. Two petals, this one and this one, are completely internal, and one is half internal, half external. So it is quincuncial and it is very rare estivation. The fifth one is called vexillary estivation. Vexillary estivation is a characteristic feature of Papilionaceae family, pea plant. It is the characteristic feature of the plants of Papilionaceae family, that is of pea plant. Here, five petals are there. The largest petal, which is called vexillum, overlaps two petals, and the rest two petals are in twisted manner, which overlaps the two smallest petal called keel. These two smallest petals are called keel. Here it appears as one. It appears as one in flower. So it is completely inside. Two are in twisted manner, and one largest called vexillary is completely outside. So these are five types of estivation. Velvet estivation, where margins do not overlap but only touch each other. Twisted, where one end of margin is internal and other is external. Imbricate, where one petal is completely external, one petal is completely internal, rest are in twisted manner. Quincuncial, where two petals are external, two are internal, and rest is in twisted manner. And vexillary, where one largest petal overlaps two petals, which in turn overlaps two smallest petals. Vexillary is found in family Papilionaceae, and it is the characteristic feature of them. So these are different types of estivation. Let's study about the third part of the flower, that is androecium. As we know, androecium is the third whole of a flower. A single unit is called stamen. Stamen or androecium is the male reproductive part of the flower. Each stamen, this is the structure of a stamen. Each stamen has two parts. A long tubular part called filament, which decides the length of the stamen. This long tubular part called filament, the length may vary depending upon the species of the plant, and the upper part called anther. Each anther is bilobed structure. You can see two lobes, two parts. So each anther is bilobed structure, and each lobe in turn has two microspongia or pollen sac. So generally, we can say anther has four parts, two lobes of anther, and inside each lobe, two pollen sacs or microspongia. Inside the pollen sacs or microspongia, the microspores, that is pollen grains, male gametes of the flower, pollen grains are produced. Such condition where anther is bilobed is called dithecus. It is a common condition. In some plant, that is plants of family Malvaceae, it is exception where anther is monothecus, that is having only a single lobe. Rest all the anthers are bilobed. A sterile stamen is called a staminode. A staminode means a sterile stamen which cannot produce pollen grain inside it. So it is androecium, and you can see the structure of androecium. The single unit of androecium is called a stamen. It has a long tubular filament and upper bilobed part called anther. Inside the anther, pollen grains are produced. Now, we will study about relation of stamen with other floral parts and with itself, means relation between two stamens. So, first we will study about cohesion of stamen. Cohesion of stamen refers to relation of stamens together. How two stamens are related or associated in a flower. When stamens are free from each other, all the stamens are free, such type of condition is called polyandrous. Such condition where different stamens are present and all stamens are free from each other, such condition is called polyandrous condition. Stamens may be united also up to different extent, and on that extent how these are united, these are of different types. So first condition is called adelphous. Adelphous is a condition where stamens are united with their filaments, means it is a condition where more than one stamen is present in a flower and filaments are united together but anthers are free. It is again of three types: monoadelphous, diadelphous and polyadelphous. Monoadelphous is a condition where mono means single, one, so one bundle is formed. Monoadelphous is a condition where filaments are found in a single bundle. You can see all the filaments are fused together to form a bundle and anthers are present over there. So it is a condition of monoadelphous where filaments are fused together to form a single bundle. Example, China rose. The second condition is diadelphous condition where filaments are fused to form two bundles. Here you can see two bundles are there and three anthers are, you can see visible over here, and three are here. Example is pea plant. It is not necessary that bundles are dividing anthers in two. Means if there are six anthers or six stamens, it is not necessary a single bundle is always having three anther and another is having three anther. It may be 4+2, it may be 5+1, but the bundles will be two. Filaments will be in two bundles and anthers will be free. Example is pea plant. Example of diadelphous is pea plant. And the third condition is called polyandrous, where filaments are fused in more than two bundles. It is found in citrus plant. So there are three types of adelphous condition. Adelphous is a condition where only filament of the androecium are fused. It may be monoadelphous having a single bundle of filament, diadelphous having two bundles of filaments, and polyadelphous having more than two bundles of filaments. Example of monoadelphous is China rose, diadelphous pea plants, and polyadelphous citrus fruits. The second condition is called syngenesious condition. In this condition, filaments are free but anthers are fused. You can see over here, anthers are fused but filaments are free. Here you can count six filaments are there but anthers are fused together. Such condition is found in the plant of sunflower. Anthers are free and anthers are fused and filaments are free. The third condition is synandrous condition, where the entire stamen is fused, means both filaments and anthers are fused. So only a single bundle is seen with fused anther also. It is found in cucurbitaceous plants. Family Cucurbitaceae, it is found. So depending upon the relation between different stamens, stamens maybe are of two types, when all the stamens are free, it is called polyandrous. If stamens are fused together, there may be three conditions: adelphous, where filaments are fused but anthers are free. Again, it is of three types: monoadelphous, diadelphous, polyandelphous. Second, where anthers are fused and filaments are free. And third condition, where the entire stamen is fused, both anthers and filaments are fused. So this is three conditions of combined stamen. Now we will study about adhesion of stamens. Adhesion of stamen means relation of stamen with other floral appendages. In cohesion, we studied about relation of stamen with each other, with stamen itself. In adhesion, we will study about relation of stamen with other floral appendages. It is of three types. The first one is epipetalous. Name can suggest you something is related with petal over here. It is a condition where stamens are attached to petals. Stamens and petals are attached together. It is called epipetalous condition. This characteristic is found in the family Solanaceae, that is brinjal. You can find this such type of stamen in brinjal. The second one is epiphyllous. It is found in family Liliaceae. Example, lily flower. Just recall, in lily plant, petals or sepals are not there. Rather, there is perianth. A single unit is called tepal. It means in this condition, the stamens are attached to tepals or perianth. Example, family Liliaceae or flowered lily. The third condition is called gynandrous condition, where androecium and gynoecium are attached together. That's why the name gynandroecium. Gynoecium and androecium are attached together. Stamens are attached to gynoecium. An example is flower of Calotropis. So it is three types of adhesion, where stamen is associated attached to petals, epipetalous; when it is attached to perianth, epiphyllous; and when it is attached to gynoecium, gynandrous condition. Examples: brinjal, lily and Calotropis respectively. Now we must know that depending upon length of stamen, stamens are of two types. The first condition is called didynamous condition. Here two long and two short stamens are present. Didynamous condition is found in the flowers of family Labiatae. Here two stamens are long and two stamens are short. The second condition is tetradynamous condition. Here four long stamens in inner hole and two short stamen in outer holes are present. So there are altogether six stamens, two short in outer hole and four long in inner hole. So this is called tetradynamous condition. It is found in mustard, reddish, etc. So depending upon length, stamens are of two types: didynamous and tetradynamous. So students, this is your assignment time. I have given you 5 questions to solve. You will get all the answers in the video itself. So watch the video carefully and write down the answers. The first question: draw a typical complete flower and name its part. You have to draw a flower and you have to name all the floral holes of the flower. The second question: what is perianth? Explain. Now you have to write down what do you mean by perianth. You will tell what a single unit of perianth is called and where it is found. It is a characteristic feature of a particular family. If you cannot recall that, you must remember the name of a flower. That is indicated in this video itself and in the last video also. थर्ड क्वेश्चन, डिफाइन एस्टिमेशन, एक्सप्लेन इट्स टाइप्स. यू हैव टू डिफाइन एस्टिमेशन एंड यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन इट्स टाइप्स विद डायग्राम. व्हाट इज अडेल्फा सिस्टम, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अडेल्फास, फर्स्ट यू विल एक्सप्लेन दैट एंड देन यू विल एक्सप्लेन इट्स टाइप्स ऑब्वियसली विद द हेल्प ऑफ डायग्राम. And the fifth question, what is the difference between epipetalous and epiphyllous system? So these are five questions. Write down the answers of these questions. Thank you.